Hello, who are we talking to?
Oh, hey, I'm James Lanning.
And where are you, James Lanning?
We're in the modern physics lab right now.
Here we are in the modern physics lab, Chef in the corner. Nice shirt, Chef, I like it. What did you do 2 weeks ago on a Thursday?
I was in the Haste competition and I was helping organize it, so, yeah.
Well, there you go. And actually, this video is for Mr. Haste. The very same Haze. So here we are. We're just going to walk you through some of the equipment that we have now. So James, can you tell us the signal we're looking at on the screen here? What is this?
Yeah. So this entire machine is a nuclear magnetic resonance spectrometer. We have like a little sample in here of like some random mineral oil, and basically what this tells us is when we apply like a magnetic pulse to it, we get this like induction decay curve. And if we like do more and more successive pulses, you can control it on here. Then you get like this big series of them.
Oh, that's amazing.
Yeah, and from that you can tell all sorts of data.
This is the so-called spin echo.
Yeah,
that's amazing.
Yeah.
Well, let's see. Supposing your sample, which is here, and I believe that you've done this a while back. Suppose this is the point. Supposing this sample, which is a tiny little drop of oil, supposing you put in some wax into it, and you had the wax was hot, then you wanted the hot wax to solidify, you would want to see this data as a function of time.
Mm-hmm.
So let's see how you would do that. You hold the camera for a second.
All right.
Well, here's what we would do. We would take this data and we put it in to this USB oscilloscope. And then we can, using the data logging pull-down menu, we could say to do each triggered acquisition up to 1,000, we can say what their name should be, and we can write them all to a file, and we can number them. So this is amazingly useful when you're taking data. But so that's one thing I wanted to say. And the other thing is this. This is an NMR machine we've had for a number of years. One of the problems is that even though you can use it, the students don't really know what's really going on inside it. Come over here. This is a recent acquisition. This, I'll just give you a quick run through. Say, Thomas and Connor, say hello to Mr. Hayes.
Hello.
Hey there.
Okay, they're doing something separate. We're interrupting them, but don't mind about them. So here we go. We have a pool ball, and the pool ball has a magnet inside it. This is a little proton. So what we've seen over there was nuclear magnetic resonance. Well, what we can do is, if we can set this little proton spinning, it's got angular momentum, it's got a magnetic moment, and then we can turn on a magnetic field, and we can watch it precessing. This precession is exactly what we can see inside the oil sample. Actually, we can turn off the magnet. If we stop it spinning, we can actually just make it. We can make it oscillate back and forward, because I can use this control here. I can put a current in these coils, and I have a magnetic field pointing up. This guy, if he starts off here, he wants to align himself with a magnetic field, and then we have a harmonic oscillator. You can use the period of this harmonic oscillator to measure the magnetic moment of the so-called proton, or We can flip the field, and we can have them pointing down. Then we can hang a little weight on them and see what it takes to get them back up. We can do all kinds of things with this. We can even set them spinning in this guy, and we can. This is another magnetic field, and we can control them with this magnetic field as well. So there's all kinds of things we can do with this machine, and it's really nice. Okay, so that's another piece of equipment. Thanks very much, Mr. Hayes. Say goodbye, class.
Bye. See ya.
See you. Thanks.